There's only one word I can use to describe the LA Rams' play last week, and that is garbage. The offense couldn't stop making mistakes, we couldn't run the ball, and the defense couldn't stop a cold. The Chargers really exposed us, and things aren't any easier this week as we're on the road taking on Kansas City. And a big question for this team is, who is going to lead this team throughout the rest of the year? So far, it hasn't really been Jared Goff. Early in the year, it was Todd Gurley. Gurley's kind of fallen off through the past couple of weeks, and since then, I've been kind of taking over on the offensive side, but we need to see Goff play better, minimize turnovers, get this team down the field, get in the end zone, get some wins. Rams start from the 26-yard line and a quick throw to Gage Carver for a 6-yard gain. Good start for the offense this week, and Gage Carver needs to make his presence felt a little more this year, but taking a look at the Kansas City defense, we thought San Diego was tough on defense. The Kansas City front four or front seven, these guys are pretty reckless in their secondary. Not too bad either. Gotta watch out for those guys. Third and four, Rams trying to avoid an early three and out as Goff looks to throw for Witten right side, and Jason Witten can't hold on. And it's a three and out for the Rams. This is just not the way that this game needed to start. Goff with a nice drop back, had time to throw, good blocking by the line. Nice throw, but you gotta hold on to the football. So the Rams forced a punt after the drop pass, and just like last week, checking back on the field on offense and already down by a touchdown. Our defense has been getting torched the past couple of weeks, but there goes a nice throw from Goff to Kenny Britt for a first down. Rams near midfield. Really good game from Britt, especially in the second half last week against the Chargers. First and 10, going back to the ground game with Todd Gurley and Eric Berry came in there. Probably should have got called for targeting. Second and 7, 4 wide set for the Rams, and Goff throws my way, picked off by Russell. We just can't avoid the mistakes. And this, honestly, this was the game. This wasn't Goff making a bad throw. This wasn't me running a bad route. This is just me pressing X for a rat catch and getting pushed up the field, which pretty much allowed that guy to just run in there and get the pick. So that is unfortunate. So the Rams end up, you know, we see good plays and we see bad plays, but our defense able to force a turnover. And we get the ball back at the 27-yard line. Alec Ogletree with the pick. Goff to the screen on first and 10, and the blocking's not there. Only a 1-yard catch. And this has been an issue the past couple of weeks. The blocking on the screens just really hasn't been there. Second and 9 from the pistol. Goff looks to throw. Quick throw to Gage Carver. Short gain. Good for 6 yards, though. That'll bring up another third down for the Rams. Third and 3. Carver in motion. Goff looking to throw, and down he goes. Are you kidding me? Justin Houston. Goff taken down, the Rams forced a punt again, and the right tackle just got run over by Justin Houston. That is not a good look for the offensive line. And I'm telling Coach, hey, you got to get the ball in my hands a little more this game. We're not really moving the ball that well. So we go to a jet sweep on first and 10, and that doesn't work either. That's another tackle in the backfield by Justin Houston, as the blocking again wasn't there. Second and 13, Goff to the air, good catch across the middle, had to go down for it, thrown a little bit low. That'll bring up third down for the Rams again. Third and 5 from the 25. Goff throwing in. We'll look downfield. He's got Gage Carver with a nice catch downfield. 13-yard gain to move the chains. Kind of catching Kansas City a little off guard here. They thought that maybe we would run. They stacked the box, and well, Gage Carver across the middle using his frame. Pretty good grab right there. First and 10, and back to the ground game with Todd Gurley, and he is brought down behind the line. 3 carries and 2 yards already in this ball game. Off to a bad start on the ground. Second and 12 to the air, working against Berry, and look at the speed, just breaking away. First down, crossing midfield again. Hopefully this time we don't give the ball away again, but that was a really nice run route. That was pretty sharp. First and 10, back to the ground game, and Todd Gurley finds a little bit of space there up to the 45-yard line. That would take us from second and 5 to third down and 2 from the 42-yard line. The Rams going back to the ground game, and Todd Gurley up to the 35. The Rams are as close as they've been to the end zone this week. First and 10, Goff in the shotgun, everyone else in close. So look, the throw down the seam, that pass is caught inside the 10, trying to fight Berry to the goal line. The field judge says that's a touchdown. Are you kidding me? They brought a safety on the blitz. They went cover 3 technically, and Eric Berry, that's a lot of field to cover for one guy, and they just didn't rotate quick enough. And that's a really great throw from Jared Goff just over Marcus Peters, who nearly got back in the play there. And that's a touchdown. Someone was going to open that play, and luckily it was me. And I'm telling Coach, you know, this is the start. We got to get fired up. This is what we're going to have to do from now on. And here goes the first punt we've seen since week 8 against the Bears. Last week, the Chargers didn't punt the ball once. They just kept the ball moving downfield. And here goes a punt return brought back to the 23-yard line. Able to get away from one guy, but brought down very quickly after. Second and 7. Rams trying to get something going here as Goff's to the air, and he will run out of time to just lob this one out of bounds as it's third down for the Rams already. Lined up in the slot, Goff with two running backs in the backfield. Lott stays in the block as Goff throws for Kenny Britt again. And Kenny Britt, nice catch, 12-yard gain. That'll move the chains. Hurrying back to the line, same formation, first and 10. Goff, quick throw to Gage. Carver inside. I'm working down the sideline. Goff had time to throw. Maybe threw that one a little too early. I was going to be wide open down the sideline with no one in front of me. No chance of catching me there. But second and 7 going to Cabrera. Nice catch for a first down. That'll move the chains. And the Rams trying to get something going here. Two timeouts and a minute on the clock. Trying to go screen to Gage Carver. And I thought someone would block that guy. No one did. And the Rams got to call a timeout. That was a really good play call against that coverage, and it kind of just didn't work out. Second and 13, Rams to the air, pass caught, pass midfield, and trying to get the first down and get out of bounds, but I end up like a yard shy. So it's third and 1 for the Rams, ball at the 43-yard line, coming out 5 wide again, just barely getting that play called off in time, and that's a caught pass for a first down, and the Rams hurrying back to the line, trying to get this ball spiked, trying to save that final timeout. 6 receptions, 73 yards, and Cabrera the last one to line up, and Goff will spike the ball with 35 seconds left. That is plenty of time for this Rams offense. Shotgun set on second down. Goff goes play action, looks to throw, and down he goes. Dontari Poe just ran through our offensive line, and the Rams, we got to call our final timeout here. 30 seconds on the clock. This is not a good look for this offensive line. Just looking confused. Pressure's been getting through pretty much all game, and then you step on our quarterback. That's a little disrespectful. Third and 17. Goff quickly fires downfield. That's caught for a first down. The Rams are going to score again. And who is calling plays for Kansas City on defense? 47-yard touchdown. And it's the same play call from the touchdown before. It's literally the exact same play call. They show cover four before the play starts. And then the safety comes down. The other safety rolls over. And I'm not complaining. I mean, I like touchdowns, but this is getting a little ridiculous. That would take us into the second half as Kansas City gets started with a field goal. And now the Rams up by 4. This kick return brought back from the 10-yard line, trying to navigate upfield. And again, I'm just running too quickly, and it's really hard to make really quick cuts when you're running that fast. First and 10 back to the ground game with Todd Gurley, trying to get him going in the second half. And a solid carry for him to get us going here as he picks up 7 yards. Could be running the ball quite a bit in the second half, trying to keep this clock going, and that's going to be another carry for Todd Gurley on second down. He picks up 5 yards at a time to move the chains, and Marcus Peters getting a little upset there. 5 wide set for the Rams on first down, going to the screen, and Gage Carver, why? The blocking was there this time, and he went the wrong way. He goes up the left sideline, around the block, and he's in for a touchdown, guaranteed. But going back to Carver on second down, good catch for 9 yards to make it third and short, third and 1. And everyone in the stadium knows the Rams are running the football. Give to Ty Gurley, and he's barely going to pick up the first down. That's good for maybe half a yard, and you'll see the instant replay here. Ty Gurley pretty much got stopped at the line of scrimmage, but was able to fall forward. And that gave us a first down. Not going to complain, though. We're getting the job done this drive. Backed up to second and 14, though. Goff to the air, and he's going to look across the middle. That's the rookie. Julius Lott able to get a first down. That's good for 20 yards. I like this rookie. He's pretty good out the backfield catching the ball. He's got good speed. He's very good in the open field. We saw that, I think, what was that, week 1 against Seattle when we were blowing them out. He ran for a 60-yard touchdown on the final play of the game, just making multiple defenders miss. Third quarter almost wrapped up, and the Rams going to the Wildcat. We run this at least once per game to the outside, and every time I just can't get past the final guy. Eric Berry saves a touchdown, and I can't ever judge how I need to play this because the camera doesn't follow me the right way. I tried the juke move. I tried, two hurdles back-to-back on Wildcat runs, and neither have got me past the final guy. First and goal, and the Rams going to the read option for the first time this year, and Jared Goff kept it and ended up losing 2 yards. Second and goal, and the Rams going to the screen for Julius Lott to the outside. Lott able to get upfield and is brought down at the 4. And he almost took this one all the way. Julius Lott, very shifty, like I said, able to get this pass out the backfield, make one guy miss, but just couldn't get past Derek Johnson and Eric Berry. But it's third and goal for the Rams. Ball at the 4-yard line. Gage Carver in motion. As Goff looks to throws for Lance Kendricks. He's in the end zone for the first time this year. And it's a 2-score lead for the Rams now. Very good drive, taking time off the clock, able to get a touchdown at the end of it. That's exactly what we want to see. And honestly, I'm not going to lie here. I like Lance Kendricks more as a starting tight end than I like Jason Witten. He just adds more. 8:15 left in the ball game. Rams back on offense, still up by 2 scores. The defense did their job. Now it's time for the offense to try to put this game away for good. Start with the ground game and Todd Gurley cutting right side again. That's good for 7 yards. We are just seeing just how this offense needs to run the ball, but we just need to do this more consistently. Second down and 3. Goff looks to throw from under center. Will roll out to his left and is brought down by Houston, who's trying to force the ball free, but he can't force the fumble. And that'll bring up 3rd and 14 for the Rams. That right side of the offensive line getting beat again. You'll just see the pressure get through. Goff did a good job getting away from the first one, but Justin Houston trying to punch that ball out like Peanut Tillman. And unfortunately for them, that fumble was not forced. 3rd and 19, Goff to the air. They brought a safety on the blitz again, and Goff looking at the wrong guy. Cabrera was wide open down the seam. Would have had a first down. But we punt the ball back to Kansas City. No score from them. And it's time to burn some more time off the clock. Going back to the ground game, Todd Gurley, another solid carry. Spread him out, run up the middle. That's what's been working for this offense. And so far, so good in the second half. 2nd and 2, back to the jet sweep. This didn't work earlier, but there goes a nice carry. Jumping over Lance Kendricks, who got pretty much bowled over on that play. First down Rams. But now facing 3rd and 7, Goff to the air. Time to throw. We'll lob this one downfield. 1-on-1. Can I go up there to get it? And I can't. I have been making some pretty incredible grabs the past couple weeks, but that one may be a little too high. But the Rams get it back at the 8-yard line. The punt pinned the Chiefs back inside their own 5, and they would end up turning the ball over on 4 downs. Todd Gurley getting us inside the 5-yard line down to the 3. That'll put Gurley at 14 carries and 42 yards. Rams back in the Wildcat inside the 5-yard line. That's Lott in motion. This time the Rams throwing. Quick pass to Lott in the flat. He breaks away from 1. Julius Lott in the end zone. And there goes the first throwing touchdown of my career. Not just the first throwing touchdown, but the first pass attempt. And this is all Julius Lott. I really hate that the camera shifted because Jason Witten did break open. I couldn't see him. And that would have been a much better throw to make. But Julius Lott making plays out the backfield. The dude is, he's such a playmaker. And speaking of playmakers, I can run, I can catch. We've all known that, but I can also throw touchdowns. But again, this was pretty much all Lott. Great job getting the catch out the backfield, cutting up field, breaking a tackle, diving in for the touchdown, making a fancy play even fancier. Julius Lott, I mean, obviously we're not going to have a starter controversy and running back, but Julius Lott, I think, needs more playing time. He's been really good for us. But it feels good to get back on track. The Rams win after collapsing last week at home against the Chargers, and it looks like things are back to normal. 28-10 win over Kansas City. The defense came to play. I came to play, and the offense definitely showed that we have what it takes to get back on track. Great game from Jared Goff. The pick was not his fault this week, surprisingly. But a pretty solid game. Only 5 incompletions on his end, and I had the 1 throw for 1 touchdown. We've been saving that play since week 1 of last year. That play has been in the playbook since this series started, and I've never had a chance to use it, and I finally busted it out this week. Just because it felt like the right time to do it. We were up in a game. We were trying to get a cheap score. It was 2nd down. It wasn't 3rd down, and it ended up paying off for us. So the Rams get the job done. Kansas City wasn't too great. Jamal Charles, good game. Alex Smith, a little rusty. And the defense for Kansas City, I don't know what was up with those play calls, but we saw 3 of the same play in the same game. They showed cover 2 or cover 4 to begin with, and then it switched to a cover 3 safety blitz. And each time, well, 2 of the 3 times they ran it, they really could have paid for it. Goff just didn't see Cabrera on that 1 3rd and long situation. But the Rams 8-1, Seahawks lose. They fall back to 6-3. And we are officially starting off the second half of our season with a win. So we got 7 more games left. Up next, Thursday night football against the San Francisco 49ers for the 2nd time this year. And then after that, it's the Vikings and the Packers. Todd Gurley, no longer the rush leader in the NFL, but I am still the receiving leader. or at least when it comes to receptions and yardage, but third and touchdowns. So up next, taking on 1-8 San Francisco. They had the first overall pick this past year. They picked up a quarterback, and I don't know what it is with San Fran, but we're not going to let them try to get a win against us. We're trying to get back on track. Good win this week, and we got to get Todd Gurley going. I think that's key for us. It'll be Thursday Night Football. We will be wearing Color Rush uniforms for the first time this year, or at least the mustard yellow ones. I think we wore the white alternates in week two against Carolina on the road. But the Rams looking to keep this season going on a positive footing. This is a big game against Kansas City, or that was a big win. And up next, we got San Fran. We have a chance to go 4-0 or 5-0. We've already played Arizona once. 5-0 in our division. I mean, we have a chance to go 6-0 in our division, just completely sweep our division competition, which would be huge. But that, guys, will be it for this episode. Hope you enjoyed. This is the last video I'm doing on my old computer. I'm upgrading to the new one, or I'm switching over to the new one tomorrow. So there won't be any videos until Monday when all my new software is installed. But I will see you guys on Monday for more NCAA and obviously more Madden. Thanks for tuning in, guys. See you then. Have a nice weekend.